roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by.
Park City Mountain Resort, the king, right over there. Three world-class resorts. Park City's in the top five in North America. Hanging's is in the top 10. So we have three top 10 resorts right here in Park City.
In these
Park City, yes.
Well, not the mountain resort. Okay.
All the world is
okay.
Park City, this world is so bright.
In 1783, two brothers, the Montgolfi brothers, owned a paper factory. And when they'd burn off their excess paper in their waste, they'd noticed that the smoke would rise. So they thought if there was a way they could harness that and capture that, they could slip the sooty bonds and fly. So they did. Any guesses what they made the balloon out of?
Paper?
Paper! Is that crazy?
Yeah.
How many people besides Skylar would go up in a paper balloon?
Picture a 3-foot
cauldron. Open flames, sparks, ash, and thick black smoke going to the top of a paper balloon. Kind of crazy, huh? Yeah, they thought so too. Well, it took a little bit of courage for these Frenchmen to get up in that paper balloon. So they took some French wine along with them. It's a good thing they did, because it literally saved their lives. And I probably wondered, how on earth did champagne save their lives? That's a very good question. In the late 1700s, people believed very heavily in witches and demons. If you're a farmer tending to your crop, or your field, or your cattle, and something billowing thick black smoke, on fire, sparks and ash coming off of it, came and landed in the field, much like we did today, what would you be thinking? Would that be a concern? Alien invaders, Satan's disciples, witches, demons? They had no idea what it was. So they gathered other buddies, got their pitchforks, axes, swords, shovels, whatever they could get their hands on, and they come out to take these brothers on. They ripped the balloon to shreds, thinking it was evil. Piled up a couple piles of wood, and they were going to burn these brothers at the stake. You know, thinking they're the devil's disciples themselves. Thank heavens the farmers could read, because in the basket was their bottle of courage. Right down on the bottom, it said Paris, France. It was the king's label. And they said, whoa, slow down and tie those boys. They're our fellow Frenchmen from just over the hill. Everybody gather around. Pop off went the cork. Pop off went the cork. Come on, baby. Pop off. Hence we have tradition. It's kind of anticlimactic. That's why we do champagne toasts. The tradition goes all the way back. Alrighty, we've got orange juice, we got champagne. You can have one or the other or both as I come around. You just let me know what you would like. And I will make it happen. Bubbles in there. Yay. I was wondering.